Hello everyone, in this video we are talking about the virtual instrumentations in LabView. LabView programs center around the concept of virtual instrumentations, which involves using customizable softwares with modular hardware to create user-defined measurement systems. An engineering workstation usually has a collection of equipment that might include oscilloscope, function generator, power supplies, or digital multimeters. Traditionally, those were all standalone benchtop instruments with their own control and user interface and fixed functionality. Each box could only do what its vendor built it to do. As technology advanced and PCs become ubiquitous, as technology is advanced and they use software to build the user interface and define the functionality of virtual instruments, which connect it to modular instruments cards to perform the physical measurements. A single PC connected to a few measurement cards can replace a table full of traditional benchtop instruments. Programs in LabViews are called virtual instruments or VIs because their appearance and functionality is designed to imitate physical instruments. And LabView files actually use the file extension .vi. When you open new or existing VI, the first thing you would see is called the front panel. And on the front panel, you would see a lot of controls like knobs, buttons, sliders, as well as the indicators like graphs or gauges like that. So this is the front panel, and there is a back panel as well, which is the backbone of all the coding. And even though like most of your time is gonna spend on the back panel, so if you want to go and see the back panel, what you can do is you can go here into the left top menu. You can go into the Windows, you can click, and then here is the option Show Block Diagram. You can click on that. So this is the block diagram for this code. So what you can do is, like, whenever you would be coding here, so a lot of time you need to switch between back panel or front panel. So there is a shortcut. What you can do is you can just hold the control and you can press E, control E. So in this way, you can switch between front panel and back panel, as you can see on your screen. Or there is another handy option which I used a lot. So that is control T. So what you can do is, so in this way, you can just fix your both screens, front panel and back panels, into your screen. So I'm gonna click control T. Look at that. So in this way, what I can do is, I have like both screens on parallel. So this is my back panel and this is my front panel. So in this way, I can just see whatever is going on. One more interesting thing, like every VI, no matter if it's a main VI or it's a sub VI. So sub VIs is the smallest VI, which is you are not gonna see it. So this is not existing there. So you are just gonna use it from somewhere else just to get some calculations or whatever, just to use them into your code. So every VI and sub VI have this front panel and back panel. That's all for this video. Thank you for watching and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please don't forget to like and subscribe to support this channel, where you are gonna find a lot of lab videos and tutorials. And if you are a serious LabView learner, I am gonna highly recommend you can go into the description of this video and you can find my course link, where I have over 5 hours of LabView videos in which I have explained each and every tool in a very detailed video with an example as well. And if you have some projects or assignments or tasks, feel free to write me on my email, which is also given in the description. Thank you.